NASA's mysterious discovery in Saturn's moon will change Elon Musk's plans on Mars. Microbial life is sought after in the quest for extraterrestrial life and life beyond our solar system. After all, extremophiles and microorganisms have ruled the Earth for a significant portion of its history and are capable of existing in harsh environments. The moon Enceladus of Saturn may be where we can locate them. The sixth largest moon of Saturn, this extremely bright icy moon has all the elements that astrobiologists believe are necessary for life as we know it to exist, including water, chemical compounds, and energy. Enceladus possesses an ocean and many of the components needed to host Earth-like life beneath its pitted, cratered, and rippling ice exterior. Even the possibility of eyeless creatures that can only navigate by sound being found in its ominous underground ocean has been suggested by some. Does Enceladus have the best potential for discovering life outside of Earth? What does NASA recently discover that will change Elon Musk's plans on Mars? Hey everyone, welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion dollar companies, space news, and the latest science and technology. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of our amazing videos. And let's get started. Few planets in our solar system are as fascinating as Enceladus, Saturn's icy ocean moon. Enceladus, however, discharges its ocean into space where a spacecraft can sample it. However, only a small number of planets are expected to contain liquid water seas beneath their icy shells. These samples have allowed scientists to conclude that Enceladus likely has hydrothermal vents that shoot hot, mineral-rich water into its ocean, and that it contains the majority of the chemical elements required for life. Enceladus, which is about the same width as Arizona, has the solar system's widest, most reflective surface. As it circles Saturn, the moon forges its own ring. The E-ring of Saturn is formed as a spray of icy particles from the moon's orbit expands out into space. Enceladus was discovered orbiting Saturn on August 28, 1789 by the British scientist William Herschel. The Greek mythological giant Enceladus provides the inspiration for the name Enceladus. John Herschel, a descendant of William Herschel, proposed the name in his 1847 book Results of Astronomical Observation Made at the Cape of Good Hope, which also included suggestions for the first seven Saturnian moon names. Saturn, also known as Cronus in Greek mythology, was the Titans' boss, which is why he specifically chose these titles for them. The frozen surface of the moon, which is only about 310 miles across, is surprisingly smooth in certain areas and brilliant white all around, according to images taken by the Voyager spacecraft in the 1980s. Enceladus is actually the solar system body that reflects the light the most. For many years, researchers were baffled as to why. Enceladus' surface temperature is very low at roughly minus 330 degrees Fahrenheit as a result of the planet's intense solar reflection. However, despite appearances, it is not a location that is chilly and lifeless. Enceladus, a moon of Saturn that is about the same size as Arizona, circles the planet at a distance of 148,000 miles between the orbits of Mimas and Tethys. Saturn and Enceladus are tidally locked, maintaining the same face toward the planet. Within the densest region of Saturn's E-ring, it completes one orbiter every 32.9 hours. Enceladus is also caught in an orbital resonance, which occurs when two or more moons line up with their home planet at regular intervals and interact gravitationally. This phenomenon occurs in the vast systems of the large planets, where Enceladus is similar to some other moons. Every time Dion, a bigger moon, completes one orbit around Saturn, Enceladus completes two. Enceladus' orbit is stretched into an elliptical form by Dion's gravity, bringing the moon occasionally closer to Saturn and occasionally farther away. This causes tidal heating inside the moon. Enceladus has craters up to 22 miles in diameter in some areas and few craters in others, which suggests that there have been significant resurfacing processes during the last few million years. An example, Enceladus' south pole is virtually entirely devoid of impact craters. Along with areas sculpted by tectonic processes specific to this part of the moon, the terrain's also dotted with boulders of ice the size of houses. NASA's Cassini probe discovered that freezing water vapor and gas spew from the moon's surface at a speed of about 800 miles per hour in 2005. The eruptions, which seem to be ongoing, produce a massive halo of fine ice dust around Enceladus and provide material for Saturn's E-ring. The majority of the material, on the other hand, falls back to the surface of the moon like snow, keeping Enceladus's beautiful white color. Only a small portion of the material therefore ends up in the ring. Water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, possibly a little ammonia, either carbon monoxide or nitrogen gas, along with salts and silica, make up the gaseous envelope of the plume, which is where the water jets originate from relatively warm fractures in the crust known as tiger stripes by scientists. Has the number of organic components in the plume had a density that was almost 20 times higher than what the experts had predicted? Scientists deduced that the jets were fed by worldwide ocean inside the moon using gravity measurements based on the Doppler effect and the size of the moon's extremely tiny wobble as it circled Saturn. The ice crust of the moon's surface may only be a half mile to 3 miles thick, or about 1 to 5 kilometers thick, according to scientists, at its southernmost point. About 12 to 16 miles of ice are believed to make up the average thickness of the Earth's ice cap. Studying the E-ring's material entails investigating Enceladus's ocean, since the ocean on Enceladus fuels the jets, which in turn create Saturn's E-ring. The E-ring is primarily comprised of ice droplets, but it also contains strange nanograins of silica that can only form when liquid water and rock interact at temperatures of over 200 degrees Fahrenheit. This suggests hydrothermal vents similar to those seen on Earth's ocean floor, deep beneath the icy shell of Enceladus. This is one piece of evidence among several. In our hunt for planets where life might exist, Enceladus has emerged as an intriguing candidate thanks to its worldwide ocean, distinctive chemistry, and internal heat. Will these new discoveries change Musk's plans in colonizing Mars? Elon Musk, the top developer of Martian transport, has advanced his target date for reaching the Red Planet once again, which is beginning to reduce humanity's prospects of landing on Mars before the end of the decade. A metropolis on Mars is the founder of SpaceX's ultimate vision, which he first revealed in 2016. A crewed voyage to our neighboring planet could have taken place as soon as 2024, according to Musk's hopes at the time. The corporation has made great strides in developing its Mars rocket since that time, but not nearly quickly enough to reach that original deadline. Musk said on Twitter on Wednesday that he now believes 2029 will be the earliest that humans will set foot on Mars, when it will have been 60 years since the first lunar landing in 1969. Musk was aiming for 2026 as recently as December of 2020. Starship, which SpaceX is developing to transport astronauts to the moon for NASA and eventually to Mars, has completed some successful high-altitude flights but has not yet reached space. Over the past 2 years, Musk has raised concerns about how government launch constraints are impeding the process of getting to Mars. Most recently, Musk even raised the possibility of bankruptcy if SpaceX is unable to construct the Raptor engines for the Starship more quickly. Even while the space tourism industry may have recently started to take off, it'll probably be some time before we see any commercial missions to Mars. And that ends today's episode. We sincerely hope you enjoyed our video. If you did, please click on the like button and make sure you share it with your friends and family. So what do you think of Enceladus? Can this be habitable? Let us know your thoughts in the comment space below. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more. Thanks for watching.